Welcome to our talk. We're going to talk about making Google Cast apps more discoverable. And my name is Ambarish Kenghe. I'm one of the product managers on the Google Cast and Chromecast team. And
I'm Amy. I'm currently a product manager on the Play Store team.
To start with, how many of you know about what Google Cast and Chromecast is? Cool, awesome. So I'll quickly, just to set context, I'll quickly go through what Google Cast is and how the ecosystem works, and then we'll get into how the apps are discovered and what you guys can do to make them more discoverable. So essentially what we have in this ecosystem is we have two sides of the equation here. We have a set of devices, and we have a set of receiving devices and sending devices. And Google Cast is a technology to enable exciting multi-screen experiences. So essentially what you're able to do with Google Cast is you're able to make TVs and large displays an extension of a personal device like mobile, tablet, and phone that you already have on you. The basic idea here is that you're leveraging the interaction model that you're already used to on phones, tablets, and PCs, the keyboards that you're used to, the touchscreen that you're used to. So you're leveraging that model to interact, but you're still able to use the power of a big screen and a powerful speaker in your living room. On the other side, as a developer, what you're able to do is you don't have to write an application from scratch here for a TV display. For example, you don't have to create a new sort of D-pad interaction model. You don't have to think about information density there. You can just leverage the apps that you already have, use all that model that you've already built, and then just use the TV for displaying information and creating sound that you need to do from that kind of a display. Now, what we are doing is we are building this technology into a variety of receiving devices. So we've shown you Chromecast. Chromecast has this technology built in. We announced Android TVs yesterday. So Android TVs has the Cast technology built in. And you'll see a variety of other devices which will have this technology built into them over the next few months and years. On the sender side, we have SDKs for iOS, Android, and Chrome. So if you have apps across these, you can easily get the SDK and enable your apps for a Google Cast experience. So that's a quick overview of what Google Cast and Chromecast is. Now we'll talk a little bit about what we are doing to surface applications that you build, because users need to discover applications that are Google Cast enabled. So I'll have Amy start the discovery experiences with Android, and then we'll go ahead and talk about iOS and Chrome later on.
And so the first thing we've done is create a permanent place in the Play Store where users can go and find and browse Chromecast apps. There's a couple different ways to get there. The first of which is in the Play Store itself, if you go there directly, there's a Chromecast tile that's permanent where users can go and consistently be able to find the Chromecast app page. The other way is if they actually go to chromecast.com/apps, if you have the Play Store enabled, that will also direct you to this page on the Play Store app. So on this page itself, there's a couple of different sections. There's featured, there's new, and then there's more apps, all of which kind of expand to a fuller page of apps that are enabled for Chromecast. The other primary way that users kind of browse and discover apps in the Play Store is through search, of course. And so when users search for Chromecast-related content, then they will find Cast-enabled apps there as well. And finally, we basically on the store are always looking for ways to create a much more personal experience for users so that each of them see content that's relevant. One way to do that, of course, is on the homepage, in this case for apps, to surface content that we think are especially relevant for you. If you're a Chromecast owner, for instance, in this case, we know that Cast-enabled apps would be especially good for you, so we actually insert them on the homepage as well. In this case, the apps for Chromecast section goes to the same collections page that you saw earlier.
We have like Amy talked about, on Android, chromecast.com/apps will automatically redirect to the Play Store page, and we've created a special page for Chromecast and Google Cast on Android, so you can discover all the Google Cast apps right there. On iOS as well, you can just, if you go to chromecast.com/apps, it automatically gets redirected to a special page that we have there where we have the app's discovery experience. And you get the same set of applications there. But in this case, you're going to get applications that are enabled for iOS. Now, if you click on an app here, it'll automatically take you to the App Store. And from there, you can install the application. And that just works as it was working for you in Android. We're just automatically redirecting to the App Store, and the app gets installed on your device. You can also go to the web experience on a laptop. Again, you're going to chromecast.com/apps, which is again prominently displayed on your home screen. You go to this experience, and again, you have the featured, new, and more sections. In this experience, if you click on app, you'll get an option to either go to the website, or you can install the iOS or the Android app onto your mobile devices directly from these from this website. So we gave you a quick overview, and we sort of announced this yesterday at the keynote as well. We gave you a quick overview of what we are doing to make apps discoverable. We continue to work more on that, and you'll see in the sort of coming weeks and months that this gets more interesting, and we'll do more things to make apps discoverable. Now, I want to talk a little bit about what you can do to make these apps more discoverable, help us surface your apps better. So how many of you have published an app on the developer console, on the Cast developer console? Awesome. So if you've already published an app, I want you to go to the, and you haven't gone back there, I want you to go back to the developer console as quickly as you can and enter the information that we are going to talk about next. If you have not published an application, then before you publish the app, we're going to ask you to provide us this information. So if you publish the app, you hit on the, you click on the edit button on your app on the developer console, and you'll be presented with a bunch of details. The one that I wanted to specifically point out is the details about your iOS, Android, and web applications, because these are the links that we're going to use to surface your applications in the app discovery experiences. So be sure that this part is right. And at the same time, you want to be sure that you don't put in duplicates. For example, just in case if you have multiple receivers for your application, or if you're publishing applications that you really don't want to be made public to the world, then don't publish it yet. Use it as an unpublished application on your whitelisted devices. Once you're ready to publish, enter this information, publish it. Know that once you enter these links, we will make them public in the app's discovery experience, and from there, users will be able to discover these experiences. And also, while we are not right now using the category information that you're providing, we have like three tabs right now, featured, more, featured, new, and more. We do want you to put in the right information in the categories drop down there, because in future, as we try to categorize your applications better, if you have the right category there, we'll be able to do that for you. And next, the other thing I wanted to point out on the developer console is your title and the image. For the graphics, just go to various experiences, the iOS and the web especially, on chromecast.com/apps, and make sure that this icon and graphics is going to look good there. And we have specifications on how big this graphic should be and how it should look, and make sure you're providing the right information to us there. On Android, we'll already leverage the information you've given to us on the Play Store, so you already have the graphics and description there that we can just reuse there. So that's pretty much all you would need to do in terms of enabling the experience. You know, enter this information and save, and that makes your application public. So that's about it. I wanted to sort of open up for questions and talk about anything you may have there. Sorry, it's too loud, yeah.
Sasha from the Sync Media. So by publishing our application, it will be discoverable by users through the search, right? If my application, our application, requires a mobile site, so it doesn't work as Chromecast application at all, and I don't want it to be discoverable, can I hide it? Because our use case is I have my mobile application with Discover Chromecast, and then my mobile application communicates with the Chromecast, launches a receiver, and only that scenario is valid. Users don't need even to see that we have another site published on a Chromecast. You understand scenario?
No, actually, I don't understand your question. So you're saying you have a mobile application.
Yeah, scenario, it's live streaming, live video streaming, and we developed the receiver for the Chromecast. Now, that receiver, we cannot launch without our mobile application, our own mobile application. Here is no any other mechanism to launch our Chromecast receiver application, yes. Right? So in this sense, when I publish our receiver application, I don't want it to be discoverable.
So I see your question. So in this, just to clarify, we are not making the receiver public. What we are doing is we are making a link to your mobile application public. So once you publish a receiver, nobody really has links to the receivers. From a user perspective, they don't care about the receiver. All they care about is the mobile application, which will help them to launch your receiver. So really what this is doing is you're providing us links to your Android, iOS, and Chrome applications, and then that's allowing the users to launch the receivers. So yes, I mean, receivers, nobody really needs to know about them. Yes. That's a good question. I think that's right now what we do is we do it organically, where we hunt for applications and we look for people, you know, who have developed interesting applications. What would help you in getting featured is we have UX guidelines on the web. So if you can make sure that your app follows those UX guidelines really well, that's number one. Two, you want to make sure the use case that you have is interesting use case for Chromecast that makes sense for users. And then we would discover them as sort of they pop up in the list. We look at a bunch of signals in terms of what's happening and how people are using these applications. So we're constantly on a hunt for featured applications. Because in the end, for us, it's great to have interesting applications up there on that list. So if you're following those guidelines and users are starting to use it, we'd definitely notice it.
I haven't got a chance to look at the Chromecast App Store page. So how does the plus one thing works there? So if I get somebody to plus one the Chromecast app, does it reflect to the organic listing also?
On the Play Store? Yeah. If you have a plus, if in your circles, yeah, you know, one of those people plus ones, let's say one of the Chromecast apps, that would send that app to the top of your list, because our list is basically personalized within a collection based on what we think. Is that your question?
Will I see, even if I'm not a Chromecast user, if I never connected my account with a Chromecast, will I still get to see that app?
Oh, I see. So if you don't have a Chromecast yourself, you won't see that collection on the homepage, but you can still access the Chromecast tile that you saw. You can get to the collection that way, but because, you know, we don't think the collection would be as relevant for you, we don't actually put it on the homepage.
Okay.
Other questions? Okay, cool. Looks like we can all get back to the game there. Thanks.